Happening.
He's not my husband.
Kind of looks like a deer.
Yeah, that is a... No, you know what that is? That's a fuel tank.
Big old mobile air compressor. Other side, you'll see where it says air on, air off, and it's got an air tank on it.
Yeah. Excuse me. Run up. Now, everybody watch their step.
Homer's famous last words.
Yeah, you guys got boots on.
Okay, I got wet feet now.
Yeah, we got boots on.
I think I'm going. Yep, I'll be in here. Can you see me? He goes back in here pretty good. It's no more water once you get back in here pretty good. Sure does get cold though. It went to an awful lot of work to dig this hole. I don't know if I'm getting this or not. Here's the old track. Looks like a mine shaft that drops way down in there. Boy, that's a heck of a hole there. Tell you what, you wouldn't want to screw around and not have a flashlight in here. you stay over here by the tree, the tree stands.
I got to look at it. Yeah, it sounds like something else dry, huh?
Hard spot on the way to, what are we going to, Poughkeepsie Gulch?
You hear that?
Are you filming?
Yes. Yeah.
Chad did this a couple years ago.
I didn't do this, it was another fellow.
Oh, was it? Oh, okay.
That's what it is. Is. I hear you doing hard. You
might have a better shot if you come at it this way.
Thinking toward you?
Angle it this way. Don't forget, we got a few more days.
Yeah, go down, get your tires wet. Trying to get up. Are you going to try and go up a trail?
You're thinking this is the angle?
There's some articulation.
Yeah.
You want to ride up with Chad? Yeah, I don't think so.
Why not?
No offense.
No, no.
I'm not going to ride. I wouldn't let her ride up with Ron.
Will you let me ride up? If you'll let him ride going down Redcombe, what's the difference? I'd rather go up this than go down Redcombe. Would it?
Like it, did you?
Oh, I don't like Redcombe either, but
it makes you hang on
this is
better.
This is I don't know.
You probably ain't gonna get it. You wanna keep
I don't see major rollover, but I could see a tip on the side.
I've already done that.
Okay. Now we'll be able to play the rest of the trip and just got pissing off.
Daddy's not gonna try it, huh? Just Chad is.
And Donnie.
Yeah. And Donnie's done. Okay, I'm gonna. I'll zoom in here so you can kind of get a good view of what it was. We're trying to get up.
Kinda. Oh, I got a fire truck. Can I do it?
No, sweetheart. Ooh, I feel rain.
You what?
I want that tree stuff to get away though. I'm gonna have to go back now, Mom.
Hold on, let me get out of the way.
I'm gonna have to go back. It's gonna rain.
I'm gonna feel bad if you don't go
back. Mama, it's not gonna rain on my glasses.
Turn your wheel left.
feel so bad. Yeah. That's right. It's recorded for
family tape.
That's right.
I didn't realize we were celebrities.
Yeah, you'd be celebrities, all right.
We probably ought to have some people watching us do this.
We're about 12,002 right now.
Is this pretty good? I told you it's on the dash. Why?
Once we came.
Now, this is California Gold's country there.
Yes, it is.
Now, it's a quarter till two. If we go ahead and do the whole loop, we'll be back till 7 or 8.
What are you talking about?
Well, the California Gulch, turn right, circle around a kind of different way, come in Animas Fork.
This is the Sound Democrat Mill. And it says that that it is nearly 100 years old. Looks like about 12,000 feet. Built in 1905 and 1906. Processed ore from the South Democrat Mine. Mill originally had four stamps. Between 1909-1914, the mill was operated by Joe Terry. Terry added three additional stamps to the mill and crushed gold, silver, lead-bearing ore from the Sound Democrat Mine and nearby Silver Queen Mine. So, pretty cool. There's a lot more here, but the interesting is, you know, talk about the value of money. According to this, it says an estimated $20,000 in concentrate was shipped from the San Democrat mill to the smelter in Durango before operation ceased in 1914. Not very much. Looks like an awful lot of work for $20,000. Little character over there. Little mine shaft. Rex, I love what you've done with the place. Now, how much are you asking for this place?
A mere $750.
Just a mere $750? Now, who's responsible for your decorating?
I had a gal from Hollywood do it. Called her in special.
She did just a fine job. It's very lovely.
She does all the big stars' houses.
Oh, I love the old stove. What a nice touch.
Mm-hmm.
From your window. It's just spectacular. This would be where I would be most of the time if I was back in the old days.
Here's a big chunk of coal that came out of the coal can.
And you can tell it was hot back in here.
I got pictures of this one. Staircase. Other than tar paper, they used animal hides.
Sure,
that's cool. That is really neat.
Sure is.
Animus forks. One of my books has this place in it. It's in the...
This isn't really Wheeling. This is more...
sightseeing.
In the mountains. This is more...
Difficult obstacles. We're about probably a third of the way through, and it's going to get progressively more difficult from here. A little bit of altitude sickness here. Well, Ron's going to be the first one up. We're going to see how he does. Ron's sporting fuel injection this year. And he has got his new 35-inch tall tires. The Ron Meister. Ron's CJ5 has a 350 Chevy SM420. I think he's running a Dana 20 transfer case, but I'm not sure. Dana 44 front, and a AMC 20 wheel. And that was a cakewalk. We're going to shut off the air compressor. Good job, Ron. That looked good. That was a cakewalk.
One way to burn rubber, isn't it?
Wind it up, baby. Wind it up, baby!
Once again, come on. Here comes the Chadmeister. He's gonna make me look bad, I know it. Ah, made me look bad. Don't like him anymore. He's now fired. Yeah, yeah, that's it. We'll use that.
That's the one. Isn't it?
Yeah, that's the one. Here comes the mixed nuts.
I didn't do any narration while I was doing yours, sorry.
I don't like you anymore, Chad. Okay, just so you know.
You guys are gonna have to pull up, so that'll
be... He's running an automatic in his. He's got the Chevy automatic. Dana 44 front, and the... Or Dana 30 front. And a Dana 44 rear.
I must do better.
Yeah.
It's a competition.
You can try that last option.
Oh, good. We're the only one. All right.
Yeah, that one. Threw in right smack dab in the middle of that one.
Yeah. I ended up working myself over a little bit further. I didn't follow Ron's line, and Ron took himself.
He's got the suspension on this good too.
Okay. Yeah, I think we're okay. We can get at least two more vehicles.
Should be good.
Now,
is
he locked?
There you go.
That's the one.
We could stand less air on the tire.
Yeah. How much air are you running?
One more time.
Watch out, Ann.
Don't run over Ann. Ron says he might need her again.
Go ahead. The insurance policy's paid up.
Ron.
There's dishes stacked up at home.
Yeah, that was the insurance. It's the dishes that are a problem. The laundry ain't on it.
That didn't work for me.
Hire somebody, see?
I'm what? In charge of dishes.
Hey, you're longer. Thinking.
Hey, go for it.
That's the line. You're the man. Watch out for the big rock.
Yeah, there's a big rock there.
Here you go. So am I hearing the...
My rear lockers, they're losing air, too.
Really?
Yeah, so I'm losing my rear locker that time.
We'll
get back home and we need to pick that apart, Ron.
Yeah, Ron?
Yeah, Ron, we need to pick
that
apart.
I like where the
head was
wrong.
You're a hell of a nice guy, Ron.
Yeah.
I got over it. Why did you take the worst part?
Yeah, nice. Oh, literally, man, did this. He's coming up.
Yeah.
guy's not part of our group, I think he's just so good.
He was only at Prince Creek last week.
Hey, Dick. Crap.
What?
I'm running out of battery.
Uh-oh.
And I forgot battery back at the Sammy. Ron's not gonna love me. Yeah. I wish you could holler at Chad and try to grab my camcorder bag again, because I'm too stupid to carry it. Dug out from the last time I was here. You know, I've been over this before, but it's never just dug out. It's really dug out on the other side. If I get in your way, let me know. It's the easier route. I am so winded right now. Dug out, isn't it, Ron? No. It's a lot more dug out than it was.
Yeah.
This is French Creek.
Bumper! You're gonna get the bumper. You got a little bit more. Right there, right there.
It's wicked, isn't it? And it just keeps getting dug out. Every year it gets worse. I mean, you've got to be locked to come out here and do this stuff, or you just don't do it.
I can't see how you do it.
Well, we're going to find out. We're going to try to get Ed's grand up through here without it.
Is it open both ends or not?
Open both ends. Watch his back! Watch his back!
What?
Hold on, he's coming back.
There's a tire back here, there's a rock back here.
He's in the hole now, the right tire is right in the hole. He's in the hole, he's off that side left. Try going forward.
You can get wedged here so easy. The right side definitely looks like it's more doable. Or, I mean, the left side looks more doable than the right side.
If I was here by myself, man, I'd feel that son of a gun.
Do you feel, no,
I'd
you just...
I'd be feeling that for rocks.
So were you kind of glad when you saw that we were here?
Yes, sir. Yes, I was.
We didn't know whether or not we need to get out of your way or if you're just going to...
No. See, I tried this 2 weeks ago today. I lost my dog. Was I telling you that?
No.
I was probably 250 yards back. 2 weeks ago, Wednesday. Yeah, I lost my dog. I didn't know which way he went, so I kept coming up. And I stopped here, and then I hiked back and looked for him. Never did find him. Well, I turned around the next morning and went back down and looked for him. I found him.
No kidding.
I got to this point, and I was like, what I say, I was by myself then. That hole had been filled in with rocks where I'd go up by myself.
Yeah.
I knew I was good up to here. This was my...
This used to be totally full of rocks. And people have...
So it used to be easier?
It was easier.
See, I've been...
But it's been dug out. And of course, you know, every time it rains, it's... This really floods out pretty good.
I thought about putting the tire up on this.
Well, you gotta swing out that way. Coming in that towards him.
I'm kind of swinging, just a little bit.
Well, I was taking more of a straight path. So I don't drop down in that hole. I think I'd like over top of this rock.
Play rock and soccer?
I'll just get on my rocker.
Mike, watch out.
Oh.
Donnie wanted to get this one video. Ooh.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Okay. Hold on. What you need to do? Rear
end
over more.
Hey, you moved that rock. I saw it.
Yeah, those samurai moved that big rock, no way.
Ah, same boat.
Do it again,
Donnie.
Turn your wheels. Sandy weighs about half that rock.
I'd move it if nobody get mad.
Yeah, I saw it move again. Move it a little more, Donnie. Move that rock over about a foot.
Right. Come on up,
scramble that winch cable.
How big a tire did you put on it?
33.
Oh, okay.
32 or 33. Looks good.
I think maybe 30 is about as big as you want to go if you're going to do a lot of driving.
It looks good, though.
Oh, yeah, I bet it does.
It looks nice.
Well, there's something wrong. You shouldn't, your gas mileage shouldn't be that bad.
In the winter when I'm not running air, I'm getting about 15 miles an hour. I run the air today.
Oh, there's something definitely wrong with it, because they do pretty well, really, most of them. Has he done anything to the... Yeah. Has he done anything, any modules to the fuel injection system or anything? No, that thing should get a lot better gas mileage than that. There's something...
Mm-hmm.
Of course, bear in mind, too, if he hasn't changed the odometer, that you're actually putting more miles on the shells, and that would yeah. You did change it?
Yes. We had a friend with see, the policeman has radar gun, and we were checking the odometer, the speedometer.
That doesn't sound good.
Piece at it, or he's returned.
This is SOB Hill. We are on, this is August 2nd. I just got to the top of it. It is a whole lot worse than it was before, and to add a degree of difficulty, it's muddy. So it really, a lot of wheel spin. It's pretty much all the Sammy can do to get over it. There's Mike down there. I hear him hooping and hollering. Mike's got a late model Bronco, full size. Locked front and rear. I think 35 inch tall tires. Well, I'd like to go four-wheeling. You wouldn't see this any other way.
That's a beautiful. Handsome in the past.
Ding ding.
That one there?
No.
This is Ron coming up. We'll do it again. Thank you. seen another squirrel, that's all.
We gotta do it again?
Yeah, one more time.
Go off. That dude had you one up on me, didn't
he? Yeah, I can't drive up.
Well, Don can get a lot out of a Sammy, can he?
Got a good shot in.
He knows how to get every inch out of that thing, that's for sure. Okay.
Oh. That thing is first time.
Oh! Oh! So close. Oh, hold on.
Grind another pound for me. Bad poor starter. It almost started. Not enough squirrels.
I saw a hot starter.
Yeah, I wonder why.
Something I do that again for a while.
That's a little warm.
Look at this.
How is it? That shack was such a big deal. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, it is.
Wake both them squirrels up.
Just not enough squirrels.
That's the whole deal, isn't
it? Here we are, still lined up on Independence Trail. I'm starting to run out of tape, so.